Okay, so your computer is now fully built. You have your motherboard set up with all the necessary components, including a brand new high-capacity hard disk drive. You have the biggest monitor you could find and surround sound speakers, and you even have a keyboard, mouse, and microphone, so you've got lots of options for inputting commands. Now, we just press the power button and it works! Now what? It's one thing to put the computer together, but it's a completely different process to actually use a computer. After all, the computer can't do anything on its own. A human user has to input commands, which means knowing what commands it will understand. In this unit, you'll learn the ins and outs of using and navigating computers. You're using a computer right now to watch this video and complete your lessons. But even if you know the basics of how to use computers, I guarantee this unit will teach you some things you never knew you could do. Let's get into it. In the first lesson of this unit, you'll learn about the basic software computers use to communicate and follow commands, known as an operating system. Anytime you use a computer, you're engaging with its operating system, but different computers have different operating systems, so it's important to understand these similarities and differences. In the last unit, you learned what input devices were and the basics of how to use them. But input devices actually have a lot of hidden features. In lesson 2, you'll learn some of the more complicated ways that input devices can be used to navigate your computing devices. Then in lesson 3, you'll learn how to use your computer's settings and accessibility features to make its systems easier to use. A lot of people spend years not knowing about these options, but they're glad when they do finally learn about them. Lesson 4 will be all about organizing files on your computer to make it easier to locate them. A lot of people, especially teenagers, make the mistake of not keeping their files organized, and then, when they need those files again, they have no idea where to find them. I'll teach you how to avoid making that mistake. And in the final lesson, you'll learn some basic tips on how to troubleshoot or fix your computer when it malfunctions, and it will malfunction. Trust me. Luckily, most methods of fixing issues that arise with computers are simple, so you don't have to be a computer genius to fix it. To wrap up this unit, you will have the option to earn bonus gold or scoops by completing an end-of-unit project. Then, of course, you'll finish up the unit by taking an assessment. By the end of this unit, you will know how to navigate computers like a pro, and then we can get into the more specific functions of computers. As always, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.